Today I'm on the prairie in southwest Kansas. It's time to fill the freezer, and there's no better meat than the American buffalo. Stick with me, for it's gonna get wild.
But I can either spear from the cliffs, but it doesn't look like they got trails going down. When you spear, you wanna throw straight down if you can, but we got beautiful oak trees right here, and look at the ground underneath them. Plenty of buffalo tracks.
Yes, there's plenty of tracks, for I'm hunting the Clover Cliff Ranch. It's here that thousands of acres have been preserved, left as they once were when the buffalo roamed the many plains. More than 2,000 strong, and the herd is growing today. Thousands of acres have been specifically left for the buffalo. It's the perfect place to enjoy the hunt as it once was. I woke up early with a 5-star breakfast waiting for me. Joining me was Corey Cribb, my longtime friend and guide. Not only the ranch, but the lodge itself has been preserved as it once was, back when it was built by J.R. Blackshear, a settler from 1860. His diligent work was preserved, and it's a really cool place to come and stay. They've added a little running water and electricity for comfort. But other than that, it's just like it was. It's used as a bed and breakfast, but also the lodge where all the buffalo hunters come to stay. Pretty comfy. From the front porch, I could see a herd of buffalo in the distance. I knew right off this was going to be fun. So with spear in hand, it was time to have some fun.
So they got a wild herd of buffalo, as wild as you can find in the West anyhow. Unless you go out to Arizona, there's free range buffalo in Arizona. And the other herd of free range buffalo is in Alaska. But this is the perfect place. The buffalo act the same. They're purebred buffalo. They don't have cattle mixed in with them. If it is, it's a minute amount. So you can experience that here, and that's what I'm hoping I can do. Normally they creep over a ridge and look for the buffalo and then shoot them like our, you know, the pioneers did with their muzzle loaders or with a rifle, and they've had a few bow kills here. But we're gonna try and be the first guy to spear one, and I'm liking the looks of this tree. I can get up on that tree limb right there, stand up there, and wait them out. They obviously come here to drink. Look here, that's not cow poop. They definitely come down here midday to drink. That's fresh, they've been here yesterday. All right. Wow, look at that. They scraped it right off on this tree. Look how they've rubbed this tree for probably year after year. This tree, if it could talk to you, you can see it's big. Look how big it is. If this oak tree could talk to you, it would tell you about the wild buffalo that came through here before we did, or at least at the beginning when we first showed up. This tree was probably and likely here. This tree has probably been rubbed on by buffalo for 150 years. And hopefully tomorrow morning, I will spear the first buffalo out of it. It's gonna be fun. Stick around. You might enjoy watching.
It's my first day in the tree, and in the distance I can see buffalo. Buffalo are easy to kill, so I've heard. And here they come now. It's high noon. It's been a long morning, but at last they're coming my way. They're headed for water, which will take them right past my tree. They're already in rifle range. And now, the beast are within bow range. I can promise you, they may be moving slow, but my heart is racing. Spear hunting has always made me a believer that animals have a sixth sense. They have walked miles to get here, but are reluctant to close the final 3 yards, which will put them within spear range. The wind is in my face, and not once have they looked my way. Somehow, they must know. And eventually, the herd moves on. So I left the creek bottom to venture out onto the open prairie. My mind couldn't help but wonder what it must have been like for the American Indian, sitting on horseback, spears in hand, with thousands of buffalo before them. Lost in time. Unfortunately, I don't have a horse, but I've got Hodgy.
Well, Corey, this ain't working, man. The buffaloes were standing around. They're not, you know, we put a lot of hours into this.
Yes, quite a bit.
Hodgy, Corey's got an idea. You know, I realized the thing with the baboons in Africa didn't work out, but this is different, and I think you can feel good about this. Tell him what we need to do, Corey.
So, these buffalo, they're pretty gosh dang aggressive. You're gonna have to get up there and just really all you need to do is kind of show yourself and they'll come for you.
So, you know, just kind of get them coming this way and try to act like you're scared. You know, that way they feel that you're submissive and they come your way. You lead them under my tree.
They're not much different than a cow, really.
Keep your distance, because they're fast. You know, they run 30 miles an hour.
I know, okay. I'm fast. I mean, they can't be that much. Or...
Oh yeah, like they're man eaters.
Those people they killed though in the past, that wasn't on this ranch, was it?
Well, I mean, only a few on this ranch.
I want you to just walk over there and then try to ease them back this way.
This ain't nothing. I got it.
So Hodgy just went over the ridge where the buffalo are, but I haven't seen him come back yet. Hopefully they follow him. Keep my eyes out behind me just in case there's a buffalo come from another direction.
You chicken crap little boogers. You guys ain't nothing. Oh, sh.
They're coming, Tim. They're what? Coming, and they're real mad. Damn, son. Run! Run! Oh, shit!
Man, they mashed him pretty bad. Yeah, he was a good guy, man.
He was.
Good cameraman.
Great one, but.
Oh well. We got the buffalo, buddy.
Yeah.
Well, you can see there's plenty of blood. Look at them legs are still stiff, so she's apparently, well, she's not breathing, but she's dead. Just died, it looks like. Wow. Wow, even when you get up close to a buffalo, and this is a female, it's huge, unbelievably huge. There's where the spear came out. You see it's a little bit back. They come running through there, and I was about to poop my pants because I was waiting. There were so many of them, they looked so big, I was thought they were going to run into the oak tree and knock me out of it, but they wouldn't buy me. And First one that got right there directly under me, I let him a little bit, not quite enough, but it did the job. Got that one lung in. What a beautiful beast. Isn't that neat? Look at that. Time for the big Tatanka celebration out here in the Kansas prairie. It's been a heck of a buffalo hunt, and I can tell you this is a grand adventure if you ever want to live it. I have had a good time here, and I got some precious meat to take back with me and a beautiful head to go on the wall and a cape to maybe cover my couch or something with. I'll throw that over mama some evening, I guess. But you know, spear hunting is a vital part of how the West was won by the Indians, and who knows who came from the cavemen to whatever lived before them, but I bet they had a spear. And I've had a good time today reliving that adventure that so many others that came before me have, and sure hope you had fun watching.
He'll come for you.
Well, can I maybe go prod him a little bit?
No. You keep your distance, Steve.
Keep your distance, because they're fast. You know, they run 30 miles an hour.
I know. Okay. I'm fast.
Well, we'll see.
They're coming, and they're real mad. James, oh, shit.
Noon.
They got him.
I liked Hodgy too. He was a good cameraman.
He was great. One of the good ones.
Yeah. You forgot your part.
What was I going to say?
Yeah, oh. But you got the buffalo.
Oh, yeah. Okay, let's try it again.
Okay.